area so that you can see it from a bird's eye view. There are also pictures of the martyred men and the families they left behind, along with some information written about them, such as where they actually worked, how many children they had, photos of the children, what they were wearing at the time, and much more. Shell casing, machine guns, and various documents are on display as well. The documents on display include memos given to the Iraqi troops during the occupation, with orders to burn and destroy all the homes on which there are slogans hostile to our leadership, the pictures of the As-Sabah dynasty, or the Kuwaiti flags. Burn and destroy every district in which any military, security, or popular army individual is martyred. Arrest any person who owns or keeps at his home a weapon. And annihilate any hostile demonstration. One damaged Chevrolet vehicle belonged to the owner of the villa, another that belonged to the leader of the group, another used by the Iraqi intelligence, the white-color minibus used to carry soldiers, and two tanks used by the Iraqi soldiers during the attack are kept. General Schwarzkopf, who visited the house on 14th of April 1994, was quoted as saying that he wished that his army had come 4 days earlier to prevent this tragedy from happening. The Iraqi occupation lasted for 7 long months, during which time many similar raids on the homes of Kuwaiti families were made, or the Iraqi army was described as a locust that ate both the green and the dry. The late Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Jaber al-Ahmed al-Jaber al-Sabah, has visited the villa and ordered to be maintained as a national museum to preserve the memory of the brave martyrs who granted their souls to defend the homeland and nation in a story of heroism and bravery. Today, the museum stands as a pride and a reminder of a path to be followed by young Kuwaiti generations. It also stands as a testimony of the Iraqi invasion.
كما أن واجب الوفاء والعرفان يحتم علينا ونحن في هذه الأوقات الفضيلة استذكار أميرنا الراحل الشيخ جابر الأحمد الجابر الصباح وأميرنا الوالد الشيخ سعد عبد الله السالم الصباح طيب الله ثراهما سائلين المولى تعالى أن يتقمدهما بواسع رحمته ويسكنهما فسيح جناته ويجزيهما خير الجزاء على ما حققاه من إنجازات مشرفة وأعمال جليلة لوطننا العزيز وأن يرحم شهدائنا الأبرار الذين بذلوا دماءهم الزكية دفاعا عن ثرى الوطن الغالي وينزلهم منازل الشهداء وأن يتقمد بواسع فضله ومنه موتانا جميعا ويسكنهم فسيح جناته كما نتضرع إليه بأن يجمع كلمة المسلمين على سواء ويحقن دماءهم ويوحد صفوفهم ويحقق لدولنا العربية والإسلامية الأمن والاستقرار والازدهار.
I would like to answer this question to tell you this story. See, after the liberation, His Highness the late Emir, Sheikh Jaber al-Ahmed Jaber al-Sabah, he heard about the story when he was in Saudi Arabia. So when he came inside Kuwait, he wanted to see this place. He asked to see this place and to meet the survivors. That's, of course, before it happened to be a museum. So he came here to see this the place, and also he met the survivors, and in the end of the tour, he asked the survivors, what do you want me to do for you? Just ask anything you want. They said, please keep this place. Don't turn it down, don't rebuild it again. We need to this place to be for the next generation. It's very important for us to this place to keep going on for the next generation. That was a very important thing. The idea of this museum, not for 25 years later, just to heard to know about the story in videos and books. No, just keep it as a museum for us, for you, for the school. You see, we have many schools here now visiting the place. They never heard about it. Maybe they just saw it in the books, but now they saw it live. what happened here. Still the same, nothing changed.
The museum was opened in 2003, where departments for documents, library and cinema were added to it. These sections were opened to provide visitors with information about the Iraqi invasion in August 1990. It also allows people to observe and learn in detail about the martyrs' incident occurred inside the house. The museum is supervised by the Ministry of Information and consists of three houses, one for the administration, another is the House of Martyr Badr al-Aidan, and the third is where the cinema, library and documents departments are located. Number of visitors reached about 70,000 in the past 10 years, while last year recorded over thousands of visitors.
Well, thank God that still Kuwaitis love this place. Still Kuwaitis visit this place. We have 25 February, 26 February. This is special occasion in Kuwait every year. We have a ceremony here on 24 every year in this place. Everyone is excited to visit this place. Everyone really interested to meet the survivors, to know about this place more and more. Really. Of course, it's very important for us to have many visitors to visit this place. On 24, we have a special occasion, started at 10 o'clock in the morning until 11. We have a special occasion to do here. Also, on 25 and 26, we are open here for our visitors to tell them the story, to be with them, to guide them in this house. Of course, the survivors, we have Hazem Jaber and the other survivors, they are really interested to be with our guest here.
The museum also cooperates with the Ministry of Education to organize visits for the students and provide them with a guide to walk them through the museum. Foreign delegations of different countries also visit the national landmark location that provides guides in different languages for foreigners. The museum also to cooperate with the National Council for Culture, Arts and Letters and the Martyr Bureau to organize a celebration on the occasion of the National Day and the Liberation Day.